Mamaivam sajiva loke.
Jiva
bhuta sanatana.
Jiva bhuta sanatana.
Mana shastani indriyani.
Mana shastani indriyani.
Prakriti stani karshati.
Prakriti stani karshati.
Mamaivam sajiva loke.
Jiva
bhuta sanatana.
Jiva bhuta sanatana.
Mana shastani indriyani.
Mana shastani indriyani.
Prakriti stani karshati.
Prakriti stani karshati.
Anybody here that needs English translation? Should I read English?
She will translate.
No, but should I read English or just let her do the translation?
Translation will be quickly.
Only I'll just do the translation, she can do the verbal. The living entities in this conditioned world are my eternal fragmental parts. Due to conditioned life, they are struggling very hard with the six senses, which include the mind.
Živa bitja u svijetu pogojenosti sa moje vječne se stanom jedinici. Jer se pogojena, bio je put baš šestni učutim, jer te dvije slada pod imom. Komentar. U tim versom je jasno opredeljena narava živega bitja. Živo bitje je vječno se stanom jedinice višnjega gospoda. Ne bi smjeli misliti da obstaja kod individualna osebnost samo u pogojenom življenju in da bo osvoboditi postane eno se višnjim gospodom. Večno je njegov se stanom jedinic. Ta vers jasno pravi, da je živo bitje sanatana. V bitah je opisano, da obstaja neštetna emanacija Vsevišnjega Gospoda. Prvotni pravi na Višnu tatva, drugotne pa so živa bitja. Višnu tatva so tudi Gospodove osebne emanacije, živa bitja pa njegove ločene emanacije. Osebne emanacije Vsevišnjega Gospoda so na primer Gospod Rama, Nrsimhadev, Višnumurti in vsa božanstva, ki vladajo planetom Vajkundje. Gospodove ločene emanacije, živa bitja, so gospodovi večni sožavniki. Osebne emanacije Vsevišnjega Gospoda, ki so vse božanske osebnosti, obstajajo večno. Gospodove ločene emanacije, živa bitja, so prav tako individualne osebnosti. Kot sestavni delci Vsevišnjega Gospoda imajo del njegovih lastnosti in ena od njih je neodvisnost. Vsako živo bitje je kot duša individuum in ima neznatno neodvisnost. Če jo zlorabi, postane pogojeno. Če jo pravilno uporablja, pa izmeraj osvobojeno. V obeh primerih je večno, kakor se višnji Gospod. V osvobojenem stanju ni pod vplivom materialne energije, temveč stan se nadaljuje ljubezni in služi Gospodu. Kadar je pogojeno, pa mu vladajo vojne materialne narave, zaradi česar pozabi na transcendentalno dobriče služenje Gospodu. Zato mora biti hud boj za obstanek v materialnem svetu. Vsa živa bitja, ne samo ljudje, mačke in psi, temveč tudi veliki upravitelji materialnega sveta, kot so Brahma, Šiva in celo Višnu, so sestavni delci Vsevišnjega Gospoda. Ne obstajajo le določen čas, temveč so večni. V tem versu je zelo pomembna beseda kašati, bojevati se ali spoprijemati se s čim. Pogojena duša je kako rukovana v železni verige. Kletena je v verige lažnega ega. Glavna sila, ki jo žene po materialnem svetu, pa je um. Če je um pogojene duše pod vplivom gune vrnine, so posledice njenega delovanja dobre. Če je pod vplivom strasti, je rezultat njenega delovanja trpljenje. Če na njen um vpliva nevednost, pa se duša spusti v niže življenjske oblike. Iz tega verza je razvidno, da pogojena duša prekriva materialno telo, ki se stoji iz uma in čutov. Ko pogojena duša doseže osvoboditev, to materialno prekrivalo izgine. Obudi pa se njeno duhovno telo z individualnimi lastnosti. Na Madhyani Maja na Šruti je rečeno. Sava ješa brahmaništa idam šariram mrtam, a ti sređa brahma visampadya brahmana pašati, brahmana šrinuti, brahmana ivetam sarvam anuhavati. Kar pomeni, da živa bitje potem, ko preneha menjavati materialna telesa in vstopi v duhovni svet, znova dobi svoje duhovno telo, v katerem lahko iz oči v oči vidi Vsevišnjo božansko osebnost. V Gospoda lahko posluša, se osebno pogovarja z njim, ter ga pozna takega, kakor še ne. O tem govori tudi smeti. La santi jatra kuraša savi vekom te murteja. Vsi prebivalci duhovnih planetov imajo telesa, ki so po videzu enaka telesu vsevišnje božanske osebnosti. Telesa živi biti, sestavnih delcev Gospoda in Gospodovih emanacij višno mutijo, se na pogled ne razlikujejo. Ob osvoboditvi dobi torej živo bitje po milosti vsevišnje božanske osebnosti duhovno telo. V tem verzu so zelo pomembne tudi besede Mama in Maša, sestavni delci vsevišnjega Gospoda. Sestavni delec vsevišnjega Gospoda ni kakor odlomljen kos kakega materialnega predmeta. Že v drugem poglavju smo izvedeli, da duha ni mogoče razkosati. Duhovnega delca ne moremo razumeti na materialnem primeru. Kakor materija, ki jo lahko razdelimo na dele in da te znova družimo. Ko govorimo o duhovnih delcih, ta primerjava ni primerna, kajti v sanskritu je uporabljena beseda sanatana, večen. Sestavni delec Gospoda je večno sestavni delec. Tudi na začetku drugega poglavja je rečeno, da v vsakem telesu prebiva sestavni delec vsevišnjega Gospoda. Dehi nos minet ha dehi. Ko se ta delec reši v jedosti v materialno telo, znova dobi svoje izvorno duhovno telo. In na enem od planetov duhovnega neba uživa v družbi vsevišnjega Gospoda. Iz tega verza je jasno, da se živo bitje kot sestavni delec vsevišnjega Gospoda kvalitativno ne razlikuje od Gospoda, kako se delci sveta ne razlikuje od samega sveta.
It's a very, very important verse that Srila Prabhupada used many times.
To je zelo pomembna verz, ki ga je Srila Prabhupada veliko pretvarjal.
Amai vamsa jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana. That we living entities are the fragmental parts, small, minute parts of Krishna.
Mi jiva bitya smo sestavni delci, majhni delci Krishna.
That means that whatever qualities Krishna has, we also have similar qualities.
To pomeni, da vse odlike, ki jih ima Krishna, jih imamo tudi mi.
But Krishna has unlimited quantity of those qualities.
Ampak Krishna pa ima te odlike v neomejeni kvaliteti.
Where we have a minute quantity.
Mi pa jih imamo v majhnem delu.
Just like this ring that Prabhupada wore has a little gold in it.
Tako kot Prabhupada je imel ta finansita prsta in ima malo zlata v sebi.
But compared to a big gold mine, it's just very insignificant. So, like that, we have the same qualities, but in small quantity. But because we have the same nature, the same quality, we're able to directly relate with Krishna.
Ker imamo isto naravo, iste oblike, se lahko direktno imamo odnos s Krishna.
We can develop our relationship with Krishna perfectly.
S Krishna lahko popolno razvijemo odnos.
That brings us to the questions of who am I?
To nas pripelje do vprašanja, kdo sem jaz?
That we're all parts of God. So everybody is part of the Supreme Lord. All of the living entities. Not only all the humans, but all the animals, the plants, the birds, the bees. The fish. The microorganisms. The spirit. Living force that makes each of those alive is the part of Krishna.
Duhovna energija, ki drži pri življenju vsakega od teh, je del Krishna.
So that's why we are all actually brothers, sisters.
Zato smo mi vsi pravzaprav bratje in sestre.
Universal brotherhood is there because we all have one common source.
Vesolno bratstvo je zato, ker imamo isti izvor.
So this type of consciousness, if the whole world would have it, then we wouldn't have so many of the wars that we have today. Right, in the world there's so many wars just because people are identifying themselves because of different bodies, different nations, different backgrounds. But if they bring it back to the original, we're all part of the same Supreme Lord. Then we can have universal peace. So Srila Prabhupada called this the United Nations of the Spiritual World. When all the devotees are congregated together. We just had a tour around India this April with 130 devotees from 38 different countries. Including Slovenia and Croatia and many others. And people were very impressed because so many different nationalities were all working together cooperatively and there was a seamless cooperation. Because everybody was in this consciousness, my bones are jiva loke, jiva bhuta sanatana, we're all part of
Krishna.
Sometimes people say, how are you going to change the world? Well, we've seen that even big political efforts and forces are not able to stop sometimes the hatred between different people. Watching what goes on in Palestine and Israel, it's very unfortunate, so many people are dying.
Opozorimo kaj se dogaja v Palestini in Izraelu, je zelo nesrečno, koliko ljudi umira.
If we can get above the sectarian vision and come to that spiritual viewpoint, then we can see everyone is one under the Supreme Lord.
Če se dvignemo iz sektaškega pogleda, lahko vidimo, da smo vsi eno pred Vsevišnjim Gospodom.
Also in Krishna consciousness, we see there's only one God. But he has different names in different languages. Once we took our tour to Bangladesh, and we were there before a big crowd, about 30,000 people. So I had about 8 nationalities on the stage. I asked each of them, tell me what the word is for water in your language. So someone would say voda, someone would say aqua, someone would say agua. Each one had a different word. But there was the same substance, water. So I said, now say the different names you have for God. So then each one said in their language, Boga, Dios, God, Allah, they gave the different names. So I said, but they're all talking about the same person, just different names. No, Allah is the only God. God is the only God. Boga is the only God. It's the semantics. It's just different languages. So I'm talking about the same personality. Of God. So these things are very simple. But because we don't have these in this world, we're facing so many trouble.